Hello traders, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're having a great day. So today I wanted to make a little tutorial. I had a question on the channel a couple of weeks ago about my charts, because I have this right here. As you can see, this is my session profiles. This is extended hours. This is regular hours. And I have my session volume profile. And then I have the delta volume profile. So I was getting asked, how do you do this delta volume profile? And so in this video, I'm just going to show you very quickly how you can do that. I'm not going to go into detail now on the regular volume profile. I have videos already on my channel in the Sierra trading platform playlist on how to apply session profiles. But if we go into the settings just for this session volume profile, you can see that basically what I have is a volume profile study, which is this one right here. It's called volume by price. This is the volume profile study. I just apply it. And then to do the sessions, you go into settings. And then this is the settings that I have. I have draw volume profiles, point of control, etc. Graph type, multiple volume profiles based on a fixed time. That time I have it set as days, so that means I get one profile every day. But then I set this here, which is important. Separate evening sessions, I put yes. When I put this, that means it's going to split it into the two sessions, which I have laid out. Sorry, I need to get out because I cannot open other windows if I don't close that. But if you go to chart settings and you go to session times, this is where you define them. Session start time, 9:30 to 5 p.m. This is regular trading hours. And evening hours, 6 p.m. until 9:30 a.m. the next day. So when I do that and I apply it, what I get is this. This is my extended hours. This is my regular trading hours. And these two together combined are 23 hours in a day, 6 p.m. to 5 p.m., which is what one day in the futures market lasts. The coloring and everything, this is all customized. I like to put this outside value area in blue for extended hours and in gray for regular hours. Okay, so that's just for the regular volume profile. But so how do I get this delta in here as well? Well, what you do here is you just apply another session volume profile, or you, if you already have it on a chart, you can even just mark it and hit duplicate to make a copy. And the settings for that is, let me just move this here so you can read this better. So the settings you're going to need is you do the same thing. Draw mode, you just put volume profiles. Volume graph type, multiple profiles based on fixed time. You put days, you split the evening sessions, but then the difference is right down here. So for the regular volume profiles, you would normally use total volume in order to just mark off all the high volume nodes, etc., based on the whole traded volume for this session. In here, you're going to select ask volume minus vid volume. This basically gives you delta. Delta is the difference between all the market orders to buy minus order market orders to sell. So you put that there in the calculation method. And then as far as the coloring, you're going to put difference of bid and ask volume, okay? Bid difference between bid and ask volume coloring. And then you're going to go into subgraphs and right over here under bid and ask volume coloring, you're going to put the left in red and the right in green. So basically this is executed market orders to sell in red and executed market orders to buy in green. And when you come, oh, then over here, draw method, put filled volume bars. And then we're, and lastly right here, make sure that where it says draw outline when coloring bid volume as volume, put no under here. Because if you put yes, look, pay attention over here, it gets all screwed up because it makes like a gray border around the lines. So you just gotta make sure you put no, so that way you can visualize them better. And then up here, also, ticks per volume bar, make sure it is set to one tick. Because if you make this higher, then you know they're gonna start just getting thicker and thicker. And then it's not gonna be very accurate because you wanna be able to have the actual delta per tick of price. So you need to set that to one, okay? And I mean, that's pretty much it. That's for the session. Let's just go into an hourly chart. Let's say, I don't know, I'm gonna get my volume profile drawing tool. Let's say I draw profile here. It's just gonna load for 1 second. This is again reloading with the pre-settings that I have set as my default. So we have here the volume profile. I have my value area in dark gray, etc. And I have it from here all the way to here. So how do I turn this into a delta volume profile? Well, we just go to analysis studies. Here's my volume profile. We go to settings, and then right here. Oh, well, you can see I have it set a tick. Well, if I'm on a higher time frame, sometimes I will set the ticks at maybe 2 instead of 1, just because you're going to see if you're zoomed out a lot, you can barely distinguish the lines. But we'll play around with this in a second. Then here, since I set a fixed range, it's just going to be from the start date time to the end. So we're not doing a daily profile or anything. And then right here, volume bar calculation method. So instead of total volume, we're going to go ask volume minus bid volume. And now we get these lines. They only look gray because now we need to change the coloring method. Bid and ask volume coloring method, we put difference between bid and ask volume coloring, apply, and now I need to go, we need to adjust the subgraphs for the coloring, then draw a line. This we're going to put no, because remember, that's going to interfere with that, with the coloring. And that's pretty much it. Draw bar method, we're just going to put filled volume bars. And now we need to go to subgraphs and put our colors. And for that, we're going to go here to bid volume and ask volume colors. And again, we're going to put red on the left, green on the right, We hit apply, and there you have it. And let's click OK to get out of here. So as you can see, you know, it looks very even. We're at 2 ticks, and look how thin it looks. If I will put here 1 tick, it will look even smaller. So let's say we just leave it at 2 ticks. And then if it's too wide here, go where it says maximum volume bar width type. I like to put window width. And then here, let's bring it down to 40% window width, or even less. Let's do like 20 right there. Okay. So if we get out now, we now have a volume profile from here all the way to the end, and it is measuring the delta, the bid minus ask volume. So what that tells us is at this levels, for example, right here, there was a lot more aggressive sellers than aggressive buyers. At this level here, there was a lot more aggressive buyers than sellers, etc. Okay, and that's pretty much the information that the delta gives us in the volume profile. If we go back here into my sessions, you can see that I always have it marked here. I usually like to incorporate it side by side with my session volume profile total volume, and I put it with the delta as well. So what I do basically is I just apply 2 profiles, one on top of the other. One is set to total volume, one is set to the bid minus ask coloring method. And that's pretty much how you do a delta volume profile. If you got any questions or comments, leave them down below. Hope this video has been helpful. As always, remember to subscribe, notifications on, and thumbs up. That greatly helps the channel. And for more information on my trading courses, my Discord SP500 group, etc., and my free student Discord group, you can check out the webpage below right there and the link in the descriptions. Okay, that's pretty much it. Hope you have a great week, and I will see you all in the next video.